In this video, I'm going to show you how the sanction list checks are done. In the Server Preferences video part 2, I showed you how to activate the compliance checks so customers' names can be checked against these sanction lists automatically when you're entering them in. So let's see what happens when we add a customer that is already on the sanction list. There's going to be two things that can possibly happen. One is a true match, and the second is a false match, which is also known as a false positive. Now, in any case, you're going to want to do some additional due diligence checks. So let's open up the customers module. On the toolbar, we can click on new, and I'm going to add someone who I know is on the sanction list. By hitting tab after typing in their last name, the checks will be done against the sanction list. You'll see that the anti-money laundering warning has come up because the system has matched this name on the OFAC list. It's giving you the reasons why it's failed. So we have the last name and the first name as a positive match. And then it also gives you more information as you scroll down. All the aliases that this person goes by, the date of birth, place of birth, citizenship, and address. We can hit OK on this warning, and you'll notice that another warning comes up. That's because the system has done two checks. It's checked against another sanction list that has been a positive match. Again, it's giving you information that you can now check against. A little bit very different, so we've got the date of birth, place of birth, nationality, and other information. Again, we can click OK. By doing this, the system automatically has checked the on hold button. So it's already creating this customer as a high risk person, and we want to put them on hold. Down on your tabs below, we can now go to the risk evaluation tab. Once we're in here, you'll see that the sanction list check log has been auto populated with the warnings that came up previously that we put that we clicked OK on. So now we can reference those as we're checking this person's ID. So you'll want to do this additional due diligence by checking their ID or proof of address, whatever it takes, just to make sure that this person isn't actually a positive match to this person that's been pulled up on the sanction list. So once you have done that and you realize that this person, for example, was born in Canada and was born in 1980, and so they're not a positive match, we can now start to check off different boxes. We can say that the match is a false positive. So although they share the same name, it wasn't a positive match. We now don't want to put this customer as suspicious, so we can uncheck this box. And then we also want to take this person off on hold. So we can click off here, and then we need to enter in our reason. So for brief purposes, we can put in checked ID and then hit save. We'll also want to do a little bit of extra risk analysis and due diligence. So in this box right here, we can put in some more information. We can say checked customer's proof of address, date of birth, and passport. Customer was very helpful and willing to provide all information. This just helps us for next time this person comes in, also for auditing purposes, just to show we've done our due diligence and really checked this person to make sure that they're not the same as the person on the sanction list. So then we also want to rate this person on our customer risk index. The system has automatically brought it through as 5, which is pretty high. Just based on the fact that it was a match from the beginning. So simply by clicking and dragging, we can change this risk index. So let's place them at medium because we don't want to presume that everything is absolutely fine because they did actually match with this name. So it would be a good thing to just keep them on a medium risk so that we can keep our eyes open for this. Then we can go to our more information tab. Right here, you will see down in the confidential notes that when we took the person off on hold and we put our reason in, checked ID, that has been filled in right here. But then we can also go on to write some additional information if we want to for our confidential notes as well. Now I'm going to show you that if in fact we typed in the name and it wasn't as the exact match and it was slightly different, a slight variation of that name, it's still going to show you and bring you up a warning that there is a similar name that slightly matches what name that you're typing in, just to make sure that this isn't someone going by a different name and it could be the same person. So you'll see that this has come through and it's telling you what the actual name of the person who could have been closest match to this, their date of birth and their place of birth. So again, you really would want to do that additional due diligence that the name is slightly similar to the sanction list name, so I better do these extra checks and these extra steps to make sure that it's not the same person.